above 16-0 start, your shots just falling well. You guys playing that well, or they give you something, or energy from senior day? How do you explain it?
I think energy had a lot to do with it. We missed the first two. When we play with energy, we're pretty good. I mean, it's hard to play with that kind of energy all the time, obviously, but that gets us moving a little bit.
The seniors in particular, is it tough to regulate emotions? I mean, they won't play so hard, but sometimes maybe they're going too fast, but it didn't seem that way today.
They're used to playing fast. I think that's a good thing. You know, some people, I guess, you know, they get all jacked up and they play a little faster than they're capable of playing. Those two guys are used to playing fast. I've done a lot of senior nights, obviously. I've never seen two seniors go down and kiss the floor like they did and mean it. You know, those two guys love this place, love the program, are and will be forever committed to this university and the people in the state, which is an awesome thing.
Bob, when did you know that there are three guys who are going to be out for this game?
Today, about noon, I guess. Smith hasn't played all year. I mean, he played a little bit again against Kansas, but he hasn't played all year. Obviously, Keenan Evans is really, really good. I mean, I think that's the. It'd be like us losing JC. That's the piece that I think really hurts him the most.
What's your favorite memory of Javon and Dax and their time here?
Well, JC, because I see it every day, I look out my window and he's down there getting shots up. To have a guy who works the way he works, he's going to hopefully end up getting a lot of accolades and deserves them because he's earned them. I'm still not sure he gets the due that he should get in this league. But he's a guy who learned. He's what coaches dream about having. Guys that care as much as he cares.
Back when as a freshman, you said Dexter Miles started because he walked out there.
Couldn't get him off the floor.
I mean, I understand there's some of that, and how much was that just his belief in himself? I mean, obviously you could have made the choice to say get out, but you didn't. What was it that you saw there?
Well, we're coming off of some bad years. I wanted some guys that wanted to play. I wanted some guys that were enthusiastic. JC was the same way. It's just, what are you going to do? Tell Javon State to get off the floor. But I mean, JC played probably about as many minutes as Dax did, I would guess.
You get the consistency out of Issa that you've wanted since he came back?
He's playing harder. You know, I think he was trying to feel his way through for a while, but he's playing harder now. He didn't shoot it very well today. He missed a bunch of them around the basket, which we've got to work on. But he's given us effort, which is, when he gives us effort, he's going to get things done. You got 11 rebounds, and that's going to happen when he gives us effort.
Anything else?
Coach, when you think about the highs and lows that the team has gone through this season, to have it all possibly click at the end, guys getting healthy, so on and so forth, worth it?
Well, Justin, tell me who hasn't been up and down. I mean, that's the nature of our game. That's the nature of our league. You can't name me a team that hasn't been up and down, from the number one ranked team in the country to the worst team in the country. I mean, everybody has highs and lows, and when you go through what a lot of us went through, you know, this year with injuries. plus it's travel, you know, you don't know anything about that anymore because you don't go anymore, so. You used to know about that.
I used to.
But, I mean, there's so many factors. You're not gonna have a perfect year. So somebody's gonna come out and play really, really well. On a night you don't play well, even if you were the best team in the country.
On the video tonight, Javon said he appreciated you taking a chance on him. I think I know the answer to this. When you look at a player, you don't care what their other offers are.
No.
But do you even look at it from the standpoint of who you got to compete against? And
I
then you're shocked.
I see them play at 8 o'clock in the morning in the other gym at the National AAU deal, and he's out there full progressive. And that's at a time when we had guys that just wouldn't play hard. And that ended up leaving in masses. So to get a guy who played as hard as what he played at 8 o'clock in the morning, I mean, I'm sitting there with some coffee trying to stay awake, and it's like, holy cow, look at this guy. You know, that's why I called our guys. I said, this is our guy right here. Got to get this guy. And then Dax's high school coach played here. So we had a connection there. Actually, Sullivan Jefferson's the one told us about him. And we bring him in here, and it's obvious his athleticism. When we weren't lacking athleticism. So, you know, you bring him and Tariq in and Jay Sean, and all of a sudden you go from not being very good to being pretty good. And those two had a lot to do.
He's got 101 wins now, 6 away from Bayshon.
They've been terrific. When you stop and think about what those two guys accomplished together, it's, I think John said that he can't find two senior guards. There's obviously been guard combinations that have better numbers, but there's never been two senior guards that even have close to what those guys have done together.
Anything else?
Thank you.
Thanks, guys.